Zombie by J.R. Angelella, narrated by Alston Brown. I have never seen a greater monster or miracle in the world than myself. Michel de Montaigne. Jeremy Barker's top 10 favorite zombie movies of all time, or How to Survive a Necro-Infectious Pandemic, The Zombie Survival Code. 1. Zombieland, 2009. 2. Dawn of the Dead, 2004. 3. Shaun of the Dead, 2004. 4. I Walked with a Zombie, 1943. 5. Thriller, 1983. 6. The Greatest Story Ever Told, 1965. 7. Zombie Strippers, 2008. 8. Planet Terror, 2007. 9. Night of the Living Dead, 1968. 10. 28 Days Later, 2002. Prologue to the Apocalypse. The earliest memory I have of Dad is disappearing. The details don't matter much now. It's more of a grainy, amateur film reel in my mind. The kind taken of some possible monster running through the darkness, or a dinosaur descending down into choppy, black water. But it's still mine. I don't remember my exact age. Maybe I was that in-between age where standing on tiptoes accomplishes things. Maybe not. The house was empty. I walked from room to room. The lights were off. I didn't turn them on or call out his name for fear of disturbing whatever might be inside. Dad was gone. But I'm not going to start with my earliest memory. If I do that, how the fuck will we ever make it through to the end? There's so much left to come. Like high school. 1. Zombieland. Release date, October 2nd, 2009. Directed by Ruben Fleischer. Written by Rhett Reese and Paul Wernick. Chapter 1. According to my father, there are three types of necktie knots: the Windsor, the half Windsor, and the limp dick.
"Jeremy, I'd bet my hand," he says, adjusting his seatbelt, "that every swinging dick at Byron Hall wears the Windsor."
"Could you not talk about dicks first thing in the morning?"
"The ladies love masculine things," he says, pinching his silver tie at the base of its knot.
"Dad, it's an all-guy high school."
"It's the principle of the thing."
"What is?"
"The size of a man's knot. His bastion of strength."
"Don't say bastion of strength. Gross," I say, shivering.
"It's true," he says. "Fact. Proven."
Dad turns, facing me, and exposes the flauntingly fat Windsor knot of his silver tie. "Welcome to Necktie 101. I will be your professor today." According to Ballantyne Barker, in order to make a Windsor, you must cross the long, fat end over the short, skinny one. Double loop through the crossover, make a tunnel over the loops, and funnel it through. The Windsor usually makes you look like a fuckwad. "What is that Bible story about the whale and Jonah? Or is his name Jonas? And Jonah is swallowed whole by some gigantic whale for whatever reason. I don't know. And Jonah lives inside the whale? And then the whale spits him out. Or is it that he swims out? Or is it that he gets blown out through the blowhole? Or does he die inside the whale? Am I thinking of Moby Dick?" We pass a sign on the side of the road that reads, "Baltimore, the greatest city in America. Get in on it." "When they say that, get in on it, what do they mean?" I ask.
"That Baltimore is a secret not many people know about," Dad says.
"A secret?"
"Get in on it. Be one of the people in the know. Be in on the secret. A part of the club."
"What secret? What club?"
"It's like referring to Baltimore as Charm City. The name creates a buzz where no buzz is buzzing."
"Buzzing?" I ask.
Dad says, "You ask too many questions."
Jackson used to call Baltimore by a bunch of different names. B-Town, Charm City, Crabtown, City of Firsts, Monument City, Mob Town, Murderland. He'd say them mainly to impress girls. They'd stop by the house in the evenings, groups of them, hordes of them. Get it? Hordes of them? And ask if he was home. They would travel from far away, Randallstown, Ellicott City, Columbia, Westminster, Cockeysville, Perry Hall, take 83 South to Cold Spring Lane, or I-95 to Russell Street past M&T Bank Stadium. Travel just to see him. They'd stink of perfume, wearing short skirts, tight tops, big hair, lipstick red lips. Jackson would emerge from his room, sometimes wearing only a robe, and descend down the stairs like some Casanova fuck. Welcome, he'd say, to the City of Firsts. What an ooze. We drive past a middle-aged woman speed-walking in pink spandex shorts and a black tank top.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.